Doesn't look like I'm gonna have a chance to call in that debt you owe me.
Don't worry. I'll pay it back to the Snatchers with interest.
All right, go! Run, Gillian!
Is this really gonna happen? But why is his name Modnor backwards? Water dripping?
Metal, are you okay?
I'm alien. What?
Metal, something broken? What happened?
That's funny.
Random blew himself up after getting us into this air shaft.
Random.
Gillian, that explosion should have taken all of Queen's Hospital with it.
The thick walls of this duct must have shielded us from enough of the blast.
Must be pretty thick.
If it wasn't for Random, we wouldn't have made it. Oh, Random.
Gillian, we have no time for grief now. We must get back to Junker headquarters as quickly as possible. Harry and Mika are in danger.
You're right. And I have to keep my promise to Random. But first, we have to figure out how to get out of here.
I can't see a thing. What should we do?
Flashlight. I'll see what's... Have us look ineffectively around and stuff. Can you see anything? It's completely dark in here. My optical sensors cannot function. Damn, I can't see a thing. It's pitch black. I can't identify anything in this darkness. This is no good. I can't tell anything just groping around like this. Why don't I turn on my light? Gee. Metal, turn your light on, will you? I was waiting for you to ask. Let there be light. Well, let's try moving forward. There could be Snatchers waiting for us. Please use extreme caution. Alright, caution. How far does this thing go? Gillian, are you sure that this thing has an exit? No. There's some kind of scratches here. Scratches? Check them out. Both the right and left side walls of the duct have scratches on them, as if something hard had bumped into them. My light isn't powerful enough. It appears to continue on. It's constructed quite well. There are signs that construction to reinforce it has been carried out. Reinforcing bars formed of level 4 hardness steel alloy have been installed. It's quite strong. And that's what saved us. I guess we should thank them, huh? It seems that this is not just a simple air duct. What is it then? The scratch was caused by the scraping of a very hard, claw-like object of some kind. A Snatcher? Maybe they were using this as some kind of shortcut, or a back route. It appears that a Snatcher was dragged through here. A human body would not cause such marks. Maybe that naked Snatcher we saw in the operating room? That's probably correct. An endostructure before the artificial skin was installed seems most likely. Well, that's how they got in and out of this place, because the upstairs, it was completely, there's dust, so nobody, you know, no footprints or anything like that. The dust was undisturbed, so they come in and out through here, because how else would they get in the basement? Metal, are you picking up any movement? I'm afraid the shock of that explosion has damaged my motion detector. So is it working or not? I'm getting partial readings, but they are not as sensitive as they should be. If we get attacked in a narrow area like this, we've had it. Please pray for us, Gillian. We've got to make it out of here. Damn. So I have to depend on my own eyes and ears, do I? If we listen carefully, we may be able to hear something. Sounds like his language circuits are being messed up again. The sensors are not showing anything. I can hear the sound of water flowing. Or dripping. Then we must be close to a way out of this thing. There's probably a sewer or something nearby. We can't go back. The way is blocked by debris. We can probably keep moving forward, but it's likely to be a dead end. Buried alive, huh? Great. Check real careful. There's gotta be a way out somewhere. We're not even trying to move forward? It's from the Snatchers when they move through this duct, I bet. Now he's saying, I can hear water, it can't be a dead end. What's this? There's some sand spilled here. How did this get here? They came in through, like, a beach? For an air duct, the quantity of dust is quite low. So that means that this thing is used regularly, right? Yes, there is certainly no reason why anyone would ever deliberately clean a duct like this. Achoo! Snow 9? Gillian, is it Snow 9? The lower surface is constructed of reinforced concrete. Alright, now analyzing the sand. Iron particles, high quantities of phosphorus. This type of sand is particular to the M district in Neo Kobe. The M district, huh? Around the old factory, right? What's that mean? So that's where they are constructed, at the old factory? It's quite unusual that this particular sand would be present here. It was no doubt brought here by someone. Pollen, yeah. Anything else about the scratches first? No. Alright, I will gather and analyze a sample of the air here. Gillian, the results are as I would have expected. Though the concentration is thin, there is definitely Snow 9 present. Snow 9, huh? Is it okay to breathe it? You'll be safe at these concentrations. This does not seem to be just an ordinary air duct. Looks like the Snatchers have been using it to move around. With these scratches and the presence of Snow 9, I'd say it's definite. I sure don't want to meet up with any of them in a tight space like this. The farther we go, the higher the concentration. It must be coming from that direction. Is it still going to be safe? Well, now we can advance. Alright, continuing forward. Jeez, this thing just keeps going. Insectors, Gillian, use your blaster. You've got to be kidding, not here. Gonna die. Hooray! Oh, good God. Saving. I'm no longer reading any motion. God, okay. Restarting my timer. My thumb is sore. It must have been at least 10 times that I'm cutting out of here. So I showing you guys failing, me failing twice, and now this, thank God. I was thinking of, cheating, but I'm like, no, let's just keep going. God, my thumb is so sore. My thumb has not been sore like this since the old days of actually playing an actual Sega Genesis. I used to wear a glove on my left hand, like Michael Jackson, to, stop the thumb soreness. The right one's pretty sore, too, but the left one's harder. They get stuck in the corners, and I hate the way the target keeps going, you know, if you let it go, it goes towards the middle. It should be free-flowing. It should stay where you fired last time, and you can just freely move around, not fight gravity or whatever to stop it, because it keeps dragging towards the middle. I'm no longer reading any motion. Whew. They really build a lot of those things, don't they? Yeah, it's much easier to fight the actual Snatchers, at least so far. Hope it doesn't get any harder than this, because this is like dragging down a pretty much just about a perfect game for me. That was close, Gillian. Yeah. I died so many times. It was beyond close. Yeah, it took 3 hits back there. Those insectors must be the security for this area. Which means that at the end of this duct... Not anymore, please. I'm not reading any more motion. Let's move on. Don't want to meet up with any more of those spiders. Yeah, please no. Look, a way out. We're saved, Gillian. Metal, don't let your guard down. Please don't give me another one.
What in the world?
The subway. Is it?
This is part of the tube liner, the city's long abandoned subway system.
Right.
You mean Queens Hospital and this were connected?
Yes, it would appear that the Snatchers were using this to move from place to place. This would provide them with the perfect way to move about while still avoiding the ultraviolet rays they hate so much.
Right.
We should have realized this sooner. The city is crisscrossed by the tube liner's old lines, and since they are abandoned, the Snatchers could move undetected as well.
Uh-huh. That's how those two we caught a glimpse of at the abandoned factory where Gibson was killed were able to disappear so quickly. They must have used this subway.
That would appear to be correct. The tube liner passes underneath that factory site as well. That would also explain why sand from the factory was in the air duct at the hospital.
So this is the trick they were using to stay out of the sun and avoid being seen while they moved around.
Yes, yes.
Now we know why it took so long to uncover them.
All right, let's follow the subway. We should be able to get out when we get to the nearest station.
How far does this bloody thing go? We're probably lost. I wonder where we are. Metal, can you see what's up ahead? It appears that the tunnel continues for as far as I can see. I cannot see anything else. That's the area we just passed through. I see nothing out of the ordinary. I meant to hit this. We were just there, Gillian. There's nothing unusual about it. The only sound is that of our own footsteps. Metal, can you hear any trains approaching? I thought this wasn't used anymore. Yeah. What are you saying, Gillian? The tube liner system has been abandoned for years. There is no sound besides what we are making. I'm not picking up any unusual sounds. Metal, how much further do we have to go to reach the next station? Since I don't know what our exact present location is, I cannot give you an accurate figure. This part of the system didn't have very many stations. We will probably have to walk quite a bit further. Gillian, what's wrong? Uh-oh.
Look, Metal! Light!
This doesn't look like a station.
Ooh.
There's a ladder.
Where do you suppose it leads, Gillian?
Up.
I don't have the slightest, but let's climb it and see.
All right. Now climbing the ladder. We seem to have emerged into an odd place.
Oh.
Wait. This room.
It's Freddy Nielsen's bathroom.
Yep.
He was using this shaft from the bathtub to get down into the subway.
I knew it. I thought it was
so
a sewer, though.
So that's how he did that.
Ah, yes. As I recall, after you disposed of Lisa, he somehow entered the apartment without using the regular entrance.
The water emptied.
Which he accomplished by using this secret passage into his bathtub.
Mm-hmm. The bathtub must be of a double construction. The bottom is actually a lid. When they wanted to hide the passage, all they needed to do was fill the tub. And to get in and out, they would just drain the water into another tank.
Jeez. Double bottom bathtubs? Abandoned subways? Snatchers really go out of their way to stay out of the sun.
Okay, Gillian, let's head outside.
I get the feeling that I'm smarter than both of these guys together. I don't know. It's like things that we figured out, like, hours ago. Like, Looks like the junk team is already taking care of Freddy's remains. The bathroom has been neatly cleaned up. The area has been sealed off by police tape. Tape? You mean this laser beam, right? Don't break the beam, Gillian. You'll have people from headquarters all over the place. It's a security sensor, you know. I see. Gotta make sure nobody messes with the evidence, after all. There's a ladder leading underground. That's the ladder that we climbed up. You can see your reflection in the mirror. I'd prefer not to be strangled like that again, thank you. Nothing has changed since we were last here. The apartment has been sealed off by the Junker Agency and Kobe City Police. After a full inspection by the identification section, the place is apparently sealed off. It appears that the faucet was a double construction, functioning as a switch as well. It's a very simple construction. We should have noticed the trick ourselves. Yes, you should have. Don't worry, there's nobody else in the reflection. I'm not reading any movement. We're the only ones here. We can descend underground again if we want to. Lisa's remains have been cleaned up. This room is also protected by police line sensors. I guess they're not hard to evade. It's a large-scale map of Moscow. Moscow, huh? Chinshu over at Queen's Hospital had a picture of St. Basil's Cathedral. The chief keeps a picture of Red Square hidden. How come everybody is such a big Moscow fan these days? What's going on here? Moscow seems to hold some clue to this whole thing, doesn't it? Moscow. Did that guy say something about it? Yeah, Random's name backwards is the one who created the Snatchers originally. From Moscow. Before the explosion, didn't Shinshu Oh say something about achieving what was meant to be 55 years ago in the depths of the Kremlin? Now that you mention it, this map is from exactly that era, isn't it? Moscow. 55 years ago. The key to understanding the Snatchers, no doubt, lies there. This has to have some meaning. I don't think they'd paste a 50-year-old map up here just as a decoration. A holographic marker indicates the location where Lisa's remains were found. We don't have to use chalk, we use holographic sensors. The apartment has been preserved just as it was the last time we were here. There is no sign that anybody else has been here since. We're the only ones in the room. Nothing else to say about it, okay. Be careful that you don't touch the tape lines. Yeah, yeah. Jeez, I feel like I'm breaking into the place or something. Or breaking out of it. We're outside of Nielsen's apartment. Thank God. Now let's get back to headquarters. Looks different here, though, doesn't it? A different time of day? This is the building that the Nielsens were living in. Since the incident the other day, the other occupants have all moved out. I guess I don't blame them. The government owns and operates the building now. Well, that was quick. Look, there's a taxi over there. There's nobody around besides us. It's a manned taxi. The driver is behind the wheel. Parked illegally in front of a house. Perhaps he's waiting for a customer. It's sealed off to prevent snatchers from spreading. The building is no longer inhabited. The area is sealed off by police tape lines. There's no sign that anyone has been here other than us. We're quite a ways from Queen's Hospital. It's very quiet here. There are not as many pedestrians in the area today as usual. People clear it out. The cab is for hire. Shall we board it? It's a black taxi, but we have little choice in the matter. Let's board, Gillian. I guess so. Ride in taxi, okay. So I think we're already using 5, aren't we? Alright. Alright, let's board the taxi. We've boarded the taxi. Where to, sir? This is a manned cab. I can take you anywhere you want to go. The car has been modified to operate on manual only. Hey, this is a black taxi, you know? Don't be so nosy, okay? Come on, stop that, please. Now, where would you like to go? I can't look around? Come on, you know the unspoken rule. Drivers and passengers of black taxis aren't supposed to interfere with each other's business, you know? His face is concealed. Polarizing film has been placed on the rearview mirror. Hopefully he's not a snatcher. From here, we can only see the back of his head. Alright. Except now we're gonna investigate. The driver's identification is not posted on the dashboard. Why not? And this taxi is lacking a synchronizer to link it to the Alpha 1 automatic traffic control system. Anything else? The driver is of medium height and medium build. As he is seated, I am unable to make a precise measurement of his height. Anything else? Nope. We're on urgent business. Get us to Junker headquarters as quickly as you can. Junker headquarters, huh? What would you want to go there for? Something going down? We're in a hurry. that some kind of a joke, sir? Can't be serious. This is a manned taxi, you know. I can't go to a place like that. Metal, I think we picked a weird taxi. Listen, I'm a junker. Take me to Junker headquarters and do it quickly. I'm afraid not. You're going somewhere else. You know, you want to know what that is? He's a snatcher. Where? Straight to hell! Chinshu O!
Is he dead?
He's junk now.
Should've known.
One, wasn't he?
Couldn't see his face.
Jeez. He made it through that explosion and was waiting for us out here. If those things ever get control of the city, there's no way we'll ever get it back. We've got to stop him before that.
And to do that, we have to prevent the chief from getting to the Kyoto summit.
I know. And I have to pay back my debt to Random.
Let's use this taxi to get back to Junker headquarters.
I planned on it. I just hope Mika and Harry are safe.
What are we doing with the body? We've arrived at Junker headquarters. I certainly hope Mika and Harry are safe. Isn't that what he just said? Alright, Metal, this is it. The final showdown. Are you ready? Let's go. Now entering headquarters. This is the lobby. Looks shot up. Wait, the shutter on the reception booth is closed. Yeah, and isn't that door shot up too? It appears that something attacked this place. The shutter on the reception booth is closed. So where did Mika go? The booth appears to have been struck a number of times by some kind of energy weapon. Oh yeah, true. This is the protective shutter for the reception booth. It is automatically lowered in times of danger. I was going to say dramatically lowered. It functions as a protective shield, so there's no way to see inside the booth with it like this. The emergency light is flashing on the door check panel. So headquarters has been put on emergency status? There are a few holes in the shield, no doubt caused by blaster or cannon fire. Cannon? Then it's Snatchers who did this. Duh. Who else would it be? Mimes? The surface of the shutter shows evidence of having been struck by fire from an energy weapon. I read motion. Something is in the booth. Is it Mika? It functions as a protective shield, so there's no way to see inside the booth with it like this. I think in this case it's just Mika. She drew it closed to protect herself. Been locked from the inside. The only way to open it is from inside the booth. We have to get the booth open before we'll be able to get the door open. Okay. Gillian, we have to open this somehow. The only switch to release the lock on the main door is inside the reception booth. Gillian, we have to investigate the booth. Okay, didn't I just do that? Oh, booth, here. Can't this be opened from the outside? If it has an emergency external connection port, then it can be opened from the outside. Okay, so does it? We have to look for an emergency external connection port. metal. Find this external connection jack. Here we are. I have located a blah 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 on the side of the booth. With this, I will be able to open the shutter. I'm just tired of saying that. So let's see what else we have to say. Okay, so booth's been removed. Open shutter. Now plugging into with emergency external connection port. Releasing lock mechanism. So save again just in case. Now opening the shutter.
All right, I'm going to open it, but please use extreme caution.